I'm Bambi Francisco with this segment of Lessons for Entrepreneurs, and I'm speaking with Mike Marquez. He's the head of M&A and Investments for CBS Interactive. Mike, thanks for joining me.
Good to be here.
So you probably see a lot of entrepreneurs who are trying to pitch their companies to CBS Interactive and, you know, probably make a lot of mistakes. So what kind of advice can you give to anybody who wants to sell themselves to CBS Interactive?
Sure. I mean, the first thing that I would say is, I mean, obviously you have to have passion for what you're doing. And I know that every entrepreneur has that passion because they decided to, you know, drop everything and focus on it. And so when you're making the pitch, make sure that that passion comes through in your pitch as well. Like, make sure that whoever you're pitching it to sees the, you know, the focus of why you did this. That's really important. The other thing is, focus on, I mean, this is, many things do get acquired, and that's, you know, a logical extension for an exit, but don't focus too much on that. I mean, there's plenty of different ways of how you can grow the company. Stay focused on that. Stay focused on your value proposition and make sure that you clearly articulate that.
What are some of the mistakes they make?
I think a couple of mistakes are, one, just, you know, too broad a reach, trying to do everything to everybody.
Sure.
And I think that
you
a lot
say,
of...
You say, how about this idea? And they say, that's a good one. We're going to put it down.
Yeah,
that's
exactly.
On the roadmap.
Or they come in with you and they basically pitch you here's everything that we intend to do. And
yeah.
You're like, whoa, this seems like a lot.
Yeah.
And so it's definitely, I mean, there's a lot of focus, especially on the earlier stage companies, really kind of trying to find out where is the value that you're going to add and, mm-hmm. you know, laser focused on being able to deliver against that. I think what a lot of entrepreneurs do is they try to, you know, hedge against that, and they'll do, you know, four or five or six different things. And what ends up happening is, especially in the earlier stages when you have limited resources, it makes it really, really hard to actually drive significant value and beat off the competition in the areas that you do want to compete in. And so I would say, make sure that you're laser focused, make sure that you know the value that you're going to provide, know the assets and the differentiated assets that you have, mm-hmm. and then continue to, you know, drive those to succeed.
And so how should someone contact you? Should they wait? It's almost like this dating game. Do you wait till they invite you or ask you out, or do you go ahead and be proactive about it? I know I met somebody who went up to Microsoft and just called and just said, you know, I want to be bought. I know a couple of other entrepreneurs who are like that. You know, one was successful, one wasn't. But how should people approach?
My suggestion always is be proactive, and it's not necessarily, you know, when you're ready to be bought or when you feel like this is the only exit that I have is to mm-hmm. be bought. Get out there, like, let Microsoft know about it. I mean, obviously there's things that you want to
let them know that you want to be bought.
Not let them know that you want to be bought. Let them know about you. Let them know what you're doing. Let them know, you know, the value added services that you're providing, not from the standpoint of that you want to be bought, but from the standpoint of, hey, this is what we're doing. Because at the end of the day, this could be a business development relationship, which is very valuable as well.
Sure.
Or it could be, you know, it could lead to an exit, you know, an acquisition down the road. But I think the thing is, and a lot of entrepreneurs get really scared and they, you know, kind of go into stealth mode and don't want to talk to anybody until they're ready to, you know, to do something like that. And my suggestion has always been, obviously be guarded about, you know, the things that you feel
sure.
are proprietary, but at the same time, make sure you're out there. Make sure that people know what you're doing, because at the end of the day, potential acquirers may not know about that. So don't assume that, you know, all these guys know about it and they're just not contacting you because they don't want to contact you. They may not. There's a lot of companies out there, and the more that you're top of mind, mm-hmm. The more that that they'll be thinking about that and potentially act on it.
Okay, so be laser focused, have your story down, be passionate, and so that definitely does come out if you're not, and be visible.
Yep, exactly.
Great pieces of advice. I'll definitely follow them. I'll be calling you. I'm kidding.
Yeah, exactly.
Thank you, Mike. I've been speaking with Mike Marquez. He is the head of CBS Interactive's M&A and Investment Unit. I'm Bambi Francisco.